Hello guys, one of my subscribers who is also my biggest supporter asked me a question. How can I make a smoke bomb that can hide me from a thermal imager? I've already made ammonium nitrate and potassium nitrate smoke bombs, but they can't block far infrared radiation and won't hide you from a thermal imager. I wanted to test this anyway, so I bought small, affordable thermal imager from Infuray. First, let's test my favorite smoke bomb. Ammonium nitrate, sawdust and motor oil. It's cheap and effective. This one is relatively large, containing 500 grams of smoke composition. Visually, the smoke looks great. It can easily conceal you, but the thermal imager shows how poorly it masks you in infrared. The smoke is completely transparent to infrared. Even close to the smoke bomb, where the thermal imager can see hot gases, they are still completely transparent. So this smoke bomb can't hide you from a thermal imager, no matter how big it is. Next, let's try potassium nitrate paraffin wax smoke bomb. Result is the same. Paraffin smoke is completely transparent. Most commercial smokes, like ammonium chloride, anthracene and TPA smokes, will have the same result. So is there a smoke bomb that can hide you in infrared? The answer is yes, a black smoke. Black smoke contains many small carbon particles that can absorb infrared radiation. The simplest black smoke composition is potassium chloride anthracene. Unfortunately, I couldn't get anthracene to make my own black smoke bomb, so I bought commercial ones. They all use the same potassium chloride anthracene composition, sometimes with no additives. So let's test them. You can see while black smoke can completely conceal you visually, the infrared camera can still see you. However, it's important to note that this smoke isn't completely transparent and can provide you some infrared concealment if it's dense enough. I tried larger and faster smoke bombs. Some moments showed complete concealment from thermal imager. I can call this a success. I tried even bigger smoke bombs, but they weren't as effective as I hoped. When I watched the thermal camera footage, I was disappointed. The smoke didn't provide enough infrared concealment. This could be because the smoke bomb uses an older formula, and the smoke is more gray than black. It might not have enough carbon particles, or the particles might be the wrong size. Remember, these smoke bombs aren't specifically designed to block infrared. The potassium chloride anthracene composition is just a simple option that works to some extent. Military-grade compositions that can effectively block infrared often use metal chloride or metal fluoride smoke. They contain chlorocarbons, fluorocarbons and metal powder, usually magnesium. For more information on these compositions, check the description for patent numbers. That's all guys, put the like to this video and don't forget to buy me a coffee. Goodbye.